What do you think is the most active volcano in the United States, with 163 active and potentially active volcanoes to choose from, and a wide range of different sources stating differing things? It can be difficult to tell. Even if you narrow down a simple online search, the top results, such as for the most active volcanoes in Alaska, are often quite wrong. And this is why I created a handy chart that I hope will now serve as the default result for the most active volcanoes in the United States, along with its various subregions. Before I unveil my list, I need to briefly explain my methodology. First off, I only counted eruptions which occurred since 1800. The reason for this is that before the 19th century in North America, human population distribution was such that the vast majority of eruptions from submarine volcanoes, Aleutian Island volcanoes, and those in the Northern Mariana Islands would have been mostly missed. This would be especially true for very small eruptions. Second, I will be giving each volcano a score of 1 for every instance where it is recorded as erupting at some point in a year. So, if a volcano had 5 brief 1-day-long eruptions across 5 separate years since 1800, it will receive the same score of 5 that a volcano with 1 singular 5-year-long eruption in the same time span had. With this in mind, here is the complete list of 64 United States volcanoes which have erupted during that time span, and this provides a decent indication of our nation's most active volcanoes in recent times. At the top of the list is Hawaii's Kilauea volcano, which has been actively erupting during 167 of the 224 years since 1800. Almost entirely producing effusive eruptions during this time span, Kilauea's high total is primarily composed of multiple several-decade-long eruptions, including a 71-year-long episode of continuous eruptive activity between 1823 and 1894. Second on this list is the most active volcano in Alaska, Pavlov. This placement makes perfect sense when you consider that the entirety of its central cone is believed to have formed during the last 11,000 years. Coming in at number 3 is Alaska's Bogoslof volcano, which has produced numerous shallow submarine and lava dome-forming eruptions just barely above sea level. At number 4 is Alaska's Shishaldin volcano, which is today at a raised alert level of yellow and whose cone has been completely constructed during the last 10,000 years. At number 5, we have the second most active volcano in Hawaii and also the largest volcano by volume on land on the planet, Mauna Loa. Mauna Loa's eruptions are typically only a few days to weeks in length, unlike Kilauea's, which can last for years to decades. At number 6 is Alaska's Akutan volcano, which produces frequent, moderately explosive eruptions. However, it has not erupted in 32 years at the present. Number 7 is Washington State's Mount Saint Helens, whose highly explosive eruptions need no introduction since it is one of the most consistently highly explosive volcanoes on the planet. Number 8 is the Cleveland volcano, whose highly symmetrical central cone has also likely completely formed during the last 10,000 years. Alaska's Okmok volcano ranks in as number 9, which in recent times has experienced fairly frequent eruptions as part of its post-caldera formation eruptive activity since these massive calderas formed in climate-altering eruptions in 76-79 BCE and 44 BCE. At number 10, we have the towering Veniaminov volcano in Alaska, whose eruptions in historic times all originated from a singular cone in its ice-filled caldera. I want to also give an honorable mention to the 11th place volcano, the Pagan volcano in the Northern Mariana Islands. I have now briefly ranked the most active volcanoes in Alaska, Hawaii, the Northern Mariana Islands, American Samoa, in the lower 48 U.S. states since the year 1800. Since 1800, there have always been between 1 and 12 United States volcanoes which erupted in a given year, with an exception of no such eruptions in 1918.